Big Snoop Dogg, it's in the game.
Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. All right, Coach. First opened in 1999. There's a good look at First Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio. The folks here in Cleveland, even though all the down years, have never stopped supporting their hometown guys, and we got evidence of that a moment ago as the Browns made their entrance. They are ready to do battle with the Seattle Seahawks. Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. Here it's Nick Chubb, gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
They'll come up 2nd and 6 now from the 24. Mayfield looks to throw. This one complete to Devin Funchess. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
That's good for the Browns. First down.
First and 10.
54-yard line.
All day, dog.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And a good pickup there. He gets about 6 up to midfield.
The Browns opted not to pick a running back with their first 2 selections at number 1 and 4 in the first round. But they circled back in the second round and got a really good one, a Nick Chubb out of Georgia. Broke off a nice run there, and that's where he's good. Good vision, able to see where the hole is, and make nice gains each time he touches the ball.
Mayfield now from the 50. He's going to go deep for Funchess. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. Now Mayfield. And this is going to be incomplete.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
He punted 4 times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And it'll be Seahawk football as they take over deep in their own territory. Wilson of the Seahawks take over now, 1st and 10 at their own 11. This is Chris Carson, 1,000-yard rusher a year ago. Showed some solid running, strong running, and then he's corralled just beyond the 10. Tackle made there by Myles Garrett.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
On second down, it's Carson, and he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. And on third and eight, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. Six defensive backs. From the shotgun, Wilson. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
The Browns drive about to get started. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6.
Alert! Alert!
Mayfield down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. And some room to maneuver. The 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Kareem Hunt. His 2nd touchdown on the season as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Extra point by Seibert up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded at the 2. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Wilson leaves this one with Penny. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. It's a 1st down on a gain of 10.
One of the surprises of the first round, the Seattle Seahawks selecting running back Rashad Penny out of San Diego State. Highly regarded, but most people thought he would go in the second round.
But he did have an incredible senior year at San Diego State, over 2,200 yards, 23 touchdowns.
He resembles Marshawn Lynch in build, but has the ability to take it the distance as well. Had 7 kick returns during his career at San Diego State for touchdowns.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, 2nd and 10.
Hey, watch the slip. Watch the slip.
This is Carson. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. Back-to-back stops make it 3rd and 10.
And it brings up 3rd down.
The threat of a 2nd straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up 3rd and 10. From the gun, it's Wilson. And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. The D-tackle, Sheldon Richardson, came barreling in for the sack. Let's see here, Charles. He was sacked 6 times last week. Now a first quarter sack. What's going on in his mind?
Well, he's thinking to himself, 5 offensive linemen. I got sacked 6 times last week. Let's start thinking about keeping extra people in. Tight end stays in. If I have a fullback or the running back, they stay in and help me block. Maybe not as many receivers in a pattern. Anything to try and slow down that pass rush.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out 1st and 10.
Y'all playing the wrong football.
1st down, Mayfield. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's 2nd down.
But one thing's for sure, when you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you're going to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. They go with Chubb on 2nd down. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game.
Let's go, defense.
Working out of the gun, Mayfield. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Bobby Wagner. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week, 3 interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away, and that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 1st down, Seattle, 16 yards, the gain there. And inaugural trip to the red zone here for the Seahawks. They have a 1st and 10 at the 18. Now Rashad Penny. And they'll get him down right around the 16. Tackle made by Demarius Randall.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. On 2nd down now, it's Carson. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd and 2 situation.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Mike, 380.
Third and two, now Wilson. To the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
On comes the Seahawk kicker here on fourth down. It's Jason Myers. And Myers able to knock it through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So three drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
So if you're an offensive coordinator and you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong line of work, aren't you? You got to find a way to unlock the key to these defenses and put some big points on the board.
Yeah, he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. They'll run with Hunt on second down. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down.
The tackle made back at the 25-yard line.
After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. On to the second from Cleveland. It's the Browns in control of the football. They're facing a tough spot, 3rd and 8 here to start things out. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. Looking for Funchess, but it's intercepted. Picked off at the 36. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Here's Carson. And he's going to get hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. Sheldon Richardson there to make the play.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Looking to throw on second down. Wilson, and this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Wilson. Now they go screen. It's complete. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. A 5-yard loss there is going to bring up fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. The wind is at his back here in the second quarter. And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. Myers, the AFC's Pro Bowl kicker from a year ago. He was 6 out of 7 from 50-plus last year, and he converts another one here. This will be taken in at the 1. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
I'd say it's pretty good strategy. If you throw interceptions on back-to-back drives, let's see if the running backs can handle the ball a little bit, get things going. And also, you motivate your offensive line. I think they're in the mood to fire out and hit someone.
I thought the defense, though, might be a little more prepared for that run. Pretty good gain on the ground. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat? And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. Mayfield on 3rd and 2. Looks to throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down. Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Returnable for Thomas. And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line. Nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And it'll be Seahawk football, 1st and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up, because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. On 2nd down, it's Carson. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, 1st and 10. Throwing is Wilson. On the move to his left. He's got a 1st down and then some inside the 40. Another strong gain on the last 2 plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on 1st down. They run it with Carson. And the running lane's non-existent in this 1st half, as they'll stop him behind the line. Play 3 of the drive not as successful. They go backwards after those 2 1st down gains. At the Browns, 36-yard line. On 2nd and 12, Wilson. And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Myles Garrett in there to get him. And on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him.
And it's 3rd down. 3rd and 1.
Wilson and the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's 3rd and long here. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Wilson hit, it's loose, it's out, fumble.
On plays like this, where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Oh, he's going to go ahead and field it from the 3-yard line. That'll go as a 39-yard punt, give him 9 on the return. And the Browns will take over with a 1st and 10 deep in their own territory.
Hey,
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Save.
A run for Nick Chubb. And he'll be taken down at the 18. They get six here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a third and four.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. From the gun, Mayfield. He's going to let this one go deep. And that's caught inside the 35. And he makes it all the way down to the 31. A big play that time for Cleveland. 51 yards. So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. They run. Chubb. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of six.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
From the 25 on second down, Mayfield, and his throw's going to be incomplete. Boy, the numbers throwing the football just not trending in the right direction. Last week, he was under 50%. He's under 50% again here.
And we haven't gotten an announcement, but it appears to me that he might be a little dinged up and is just trying to play through. You know, he's one of those tough guys that wants to answer the bell each and every play for his team. That might be throwing off his accuracy.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. On third down, here's Hunt. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really shred your defense.
Seibert able to knock this one through. And they bump the lead up to four now at 10-6. So that's a seven-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
Yeah, things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front seven? As they got closer to the goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
That's fielded in the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive, and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs, and that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining.
Come on, man. Let's go.
A reminder. reminder once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 10 yards and a Seattle first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To throw is Wilson. Flush to his right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
It's been my observation. There's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit. But only the second quarter. A lot of time to change things. And he's got this down to the 35. 15 yards on the play. First down.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be second and 11. Now Wilson. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. Operating from the gun, Wilson. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the right hash, this from 48. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. So a very tight first half. We had to break in a one-point game. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Penny. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, 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 and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Mike's short too.
On third down, Wilson. He'll lock it with a grab over the middle. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. Wilson to lock it there for the Seahawk first down. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. On the run, it's Penny. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Throwing on second down, Wilson. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. That one going to be complete to David Moore. First time they've looked his way in this game. He comes through picking up the first.
A gain of 14. First down, Seattle.
Flex 315.
Number 53, Mike 53.
They'll run on first down. It's Carson, and they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. The stop was made by Jannard Avery. Throwing on second and 8, Wilson. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Miles Garrett racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Wilson and the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. From the gun, Wilson. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but the other team doesn't get it. That's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble. That could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it. He loses it. Somehow, ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. They'll start with Hunt on the ground. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second and 9, Mayfield. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave them trying to convert on third and 9. Mayfield to throw it. And that will be incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him. Find him.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. Here's Thomas. 12 yards on the return that time. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. 14. Here's Wilson. He gets it to his running back, Rashad Penny. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. And the
Seahawks. Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
On first down. Carson, and not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Wilson, looking left side, that's caught by Moore. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 11 yards there, first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Jannard Avery coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now it's Wilson. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Sheldon Richardson able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. Here's Wilson. He's going to air one out. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
And we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. The Cleveland offense ready to go. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Brings up second and 7 at the 23-yard line.
Now second and seven from the 23.
Watch 54. Tackle.
They run it again with Chubb. In on the tackle there, Bobby Wagner, coming off a third straight All-Pro season.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Real.
Throwing, Mayfield. He's got his tight end, David Njoku. Just what the Browns needed there. Good for a gain of 17.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Mayfield now, he's hit on just 5 of 15 throws, a poor percentage, but it's first and 10. Mayfield looks to throw. Man open, that's Damian Ratley. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A very solid gain of 27. And we're back now here in Cleveland. This one's still anybody's ball game. It's a one-point difference here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. So the solid run on first, and I would imagine no real hurry to run that 2nd down play.
No, it's all in your quarterback now. He's going to keep an eye on the play clock and bleed things down, and he's not going to let the ball be snapped until it's inside 3 seconds left on the play clock. Unless, of course, you're playing a video game, you're trying to run it up on your friend.
Nice touch. Cold-blooded, too. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. Great mix of play calling so far. 3 runs, 3 passes. All 3 passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
They'll run with Chubb. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3. Good gain there on first down. It keeps him in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front. Good blocking. Nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage. Stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
They're not in any rush offensively. They'll give it to Chubb, and he takes this one in for a Brown score. Nick Chubb, his 3rd touchdown now on the year, and the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. And there you go, nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football, good blocking, beats good tackling on that play, end result, touchdown.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a 2-point conversion to tie it. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away, and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something bad to be gained from it.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And it's a fumble. And this is picked up by the Browns. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Looking to throw on second down. Wilson eluding the pressure right. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. Well, there have been a ton of sacks. They were just trying to prevent another.
So what you're telling me is the conventional way has not really worked for them, huh?
Not at all.
Not at all. So he tries to grab him here, and they still get caught.
Now after the holding call here, second and 20. Wilson from the gun, he'll throw. Finding some room at midfield. That's complete to Sterling. And finally brought down right at the midfield stripe. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty. And for the Browns, a nickel set here on third down. From midfield now, here's Wilson. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the... That's caught inside the 20. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A gain of 32 that time.
And the Seahawks, first down.